Hi, this is Marty from Blue Lightning TV. I'm going to show you how to transform your photos into beautiful impressionist paintings, and then how to create an action that will instantly apply this effect to other photos. This is an update of a tutorial I did quite a while ago on an earlier version of Photoshop. Before we begin, you can get the most current version of Photoshop and Lightroom and 20 gigabytes of cloud storage all together for only $7.99 per month. Click the link in my video's description to get the discount. Find a photo you'd like to use for this project. I provided this image of Claude Monet's Impressionist painting as our color source. The link to this image is in my video's description or project files. The first step is to crop your photo to a size and resolution that will give us the best results from the filters we'll be using. Open your crop tool. Clear any size that may be in the width field. We'll leave it empty. In the height field, type in 750px for pixels, and for the resolution, type in 150. Go to a corner and drag in the crop's bounding box. Drag your photo to reposition it. Continue to drag in corners to size it and position your image until you're happy with the way it's cropped. Make sure Delete Crop Pixels is checked, and then either click the check mark or press Enter or Return to crop your image. To fit it onto your canvas, press Ctrl or Command 0. We're ready to create an action that will ultimately record all of our steps in creating the Impressionist painting effect. Click the icon at the upper right corner of the Actions panel. If you don't see this panel, go to Window and check Actions. Click New Set. For the name, type in Impressionist painting and click OK. We now have a new action set. Open back the flyout list and this time click New Action. Click Record. At the lower right corner, you'll see a red circle appear. This lets us know that it'll record each step until we click the stop icon to its left. Keep in mind, it'll record the steps, but not the time in between the steps, so take as much time as you need before each step. Make a copy of the layer by pressing Ctrl or Command J. Go to Image, Adjustments, and Match Color. The luminance and color intensity are 100, and the fade is 0. Open the Source Flyout list and click the Monet painting I provided. If you don't see it in the list, it's because you need to open it in Photoshop as one of your documents that you can click on. Once it's in the Match Colors source list, click on it and click OK. Make a copy of the layer and name it Pointillize. Name the layer below it Dry Brush. Make the top layer active and go to Filter, Pixelate, and Pointillize. Make the cell size 3 and click OK. Reduce its opacity to 50%. Make the dry brush layer active and go back to Filter and Filter Gallery. Open the Artistic folder and click Dry Brush. Make the cell size 3, the detail 10, and the texture 1. Then click OK. Next, we'll adjust its brightness and contrast. Make the top layer active. Click the Adjustment Layer icon and click Levels. Drag the input white level to the point where the histogram starts to dramatically rise and drag the input black level also to a similar area on the histogram. We're ready to stop recording the action. Click the square icon to the left of the record button to end the action. Scroll to the top of the Actions panel and to save space, collapse Action 1. Let's test the action on another photo. Open the photo and crop it. Fit it back onto your canvas. Click Action 1 and click the Play button. Automatically and almost instantly, it applied every step that we recorded in the Impressionist painting action set. Since every photo has its own brightness and contrast characteristics, we can finesse the input levels to suit the new photo. This is Marty from Blue Lightning TV. Thanks for watching.